Hello, everyone. Today, we're doing something a bit different. There won't be any benchmarks or progress reports. Instead, I want to have a conversation with you about the uncertain future of Switch emulation and hear your thoughts as well. First, let's talk about the most promising Switch emulator for Windows, Sudachi. Recently, there have been updates that promise to resolve issues like RAM leakage and memory optimization. However, in practice, at least on Windows, these improvements haven't made much of a difference. I've tested various games on the two main emulators, and the conclusion is that performance has remained the same since the last early access version of Yuzu. Sudachi has been receiving updates at a slower pace than we'd like, and they've mainly brought improvements to games released in the past year. These recent updates include games like the new Princess Peach title, which was considered underwhelming by the community and still has issues, and the new Paper Mario, another niche game that didn't make a big impact. The problem is that since the end of the Switch's life cycle, we haven't seen any major updates, like those that truly boosted emulator performance and compatibility. During the last days of development, the Yuzu team was focused on Project Yume. For those of you who have been following the channel for a while, you know this project held a lot of promise, allowing several games to run with just 8 GB of RAM. Although this didn't make much difference on PCs, on Android, it would have been revolutionary. This project also promised other significant improvements, and every time they implemented part of the code, we could see the difference on screen, with more FPS and previously problematic games becoming playable. But have you noticed that I haven't brought this kind of news for almost a year now? Sadly, it seems that cycle has come to an end. The Sudachi developer, working alone and still getting familiar with the project, hasn't managed to implement any groundbreaking changes so far. And what's left for us? Projects like Torzu and Yusha seem questionable. If the Sudachi developer, who has shown competence and knowledge, can't deliver significant improvements, why would we trust projects like Torzu and Yusha? Personally, I don't. I could do a comparison test between them, like I recently did between Yuzu and Sudachi, if you're interested, but my confidence in these projects is very low. Speaking of credibility, I recently visited the websites of Torzu and Xionx, and they have identical layouts. What doesn't work on one site also doesn't work on the other. Additionally, one project promotes the other, and Xionx even provides files that can't be freely distributed. So, even if I wanted to make a video about these projects, I'm not sure I could find a safe source to download these emulators. So, what's left for us? Unfortunately, only Ryujinx. It's the only emulator that Nintendo hasn't targeted yet, and despite having less popularity compared to Yuzu Forks, especially due to lower performance on entry-level PCs, it's the only original emulator that continues to develop. As you can see in the background, almost all updates for new games, like the Castlevania Collection, a Nintendo DS port, or the new Lollipop Chainsaw, receive fixes on Ryujinx first. At the moment, Ryujinx has also been receiving many updates for ARM PCs, and as we all know, with the implementation of several ARM instructions, it becomes easier to bring the project to Android. However, it seems that the development team isn't very interested in taking that path. Knowing the Android fanbase, they might be avoiding a huge headache, and that's totally understandable. When it comes to Switch emulation on Android, the situation is even worse. Previously, we had Sudachi, but now the emulator is buggy. If you have version 1.0.4, you're likely facing issues installing new content, such as updates or DLCs, or even crashes when launching a game configured in SuperXCI mode, where all DLC and update files are in a single file. In this case, the recommendation is to revert to version 1.0.2, but the developer has stopped distributing all versions for Android for unknown reasons. This leaves us stuck on version 1.0.2, while the PC version is stalled at 1.0.7, and we don't know if new Android versions will ever appear. Some say the project is abandoned for Android, but I ask you to be patient, as Sudachi is developed by just one person. For those having trouble finding a link to download the project, I'll leave the link for version 1.0.2 directly from the Wayback Machine in the description. Additionally, on Android, we are mostly left with questionable projects. Just as I mentioned suspicious projects on Windows, the situation on Android is even more delicate. Do you feel safe installing a dubious app that puts your social media data and banking information at risk? In today's world, practically all our lives are on mobile devices. Every word you type can be exposed as public information and cause significant financial distress. Anyone who has had their credit card compromised by a merchant knows the impact this can have. Therefore, I wouldn't trust emulators like Nishu, Xionx, Pine, and Torzu. There are so many strange things behind these projects that I'll show you one of them, the Nyusha page, which is probably not official, displays the Xiong logo when asking for permission to send web notifications. Their GitHub pages have all been banned, but this is due to Nintendo's DMCA notices. Analyzing these pages, all are built on the WordPress platform, follow the same pattern, and have the same functions, or lack thereof. And in the worst case scenario, we have EGNS, a Chinese emulator that requires purchasing specific controllers for unlimited access to the project. EGNS is a poorly made copy of the first version of Yuzu NC, with no real improvements, only making things worse with its aggressive ad system. I understand if you trust these projects, but I urge you to evaluate the information I presented and see if it's really worth continuing to trust them. And speaking of Pine, we cannot overlook Strato. First, I'd like you to leave in the comments, who still trusts Strato? At the moment I'm writing this script, I'm posting a poll, and by the time I edit this video, I'll include a screenshot of the results for you to see. Strato was supposed to be a project with native code for Android, where all functions would be developed specifically for it and not adapted from other projects, avoiding inherited problems from different operating systems. In theory, this sounds fantastic. However, continuing the legacy of Skyline seems to be a challenge for Strato. Unlike other projects for different platforms, like CMU for Android, which brings significant updates and improvements almost every month, Strato remains in closed testing, accessible only to trusted individuals who show only what suits them. Many view Strato as a project that will never see the light of day. For others, it may be the miracle of emulation on Android and the continuation of the legacy started by Yuzu. But so far, the situation remains uncertain. Lastly, we have Yuzui, now rebranded as Yuzui EX. Since its launch, the project has been surrounded by controversy, with many accusing it of stealing code from Sudachi. However, as you can see in the background, it offers slightly better performance than Sudachi, at least on my device. Yuzui incorporates various performance hacks and RAM management options, which are essential on Android, where this is still a serious issue. It's the only emulator that continues to receive constant updates. At the time I'm writing this script, they have been banned from Discord again, likely due to another DMCA notice from Nintendo, something that has happened in the past and affected communities like Sudachi and the now-defunct Suyu. I tested the early versions of Yuzui and later Yuzui Edge, but I didn't notice much difference between them. I haven't tested Yuzui EX yet. With its performance hacks, advanced RAM management, and the AnTuTu trick, which allows the device to deliver more performance to the emulator without root, the system believes you are running a benchmark. This can make the project perform better than others. But the big question is it reliable? Some people believe so, others do not. For a while, Yuzui's code was open, but Nintendo took down the repository. I used the project and had no issues with my device, but use it at your own risk. In the end, it does not provide quick improvements like Ryujinx does for PC, nor does it deliver a 60% performance boost like Yuzui used to. However, for those experiencing performance issues, it may be a good option. To conclude, my friends, the situation is complicated, no matter where you prefer to play your favorite games. If you enjoyed this discussion, please give the video a like so more people can understand the current scenario. And if it's your first time here, consider subscribing to the channel. Thank you for your audience, and see you in the next video.